Okay, guys, we are back, refreshed and ready to go.
Matt, your dude.
Here's your guy. We have just killed a bunch of coyotes, and y'all are continuing down the trail, or path, or yeah, I guess you call it a trail, towards Bryson City.
Did we find anything at the last little stone circle?
Yeah, it's over there.
No, you found nothing of note.
Okay.
Nothing to note? Can we, I'm going to talk to everyone.
Maybe we should take note of this area, you know, in case anyone talks about this bloodstone.
Fuck, yes.
The rune still going off?
I pull out a little notepad and just scribble real quick about it.
Always okay. Been except the ones that have been. There's a total of four runes that are kind of, like, dimmed out.
Well, I'm going to try to, like, look around this little... like stone thing.
We should take note of the runes.
Yeah, well, you can do that. Right.
9 plus I don't know what.
Observe, which is your percentage of comprehension, too.
So 11.
That's pretty much what.
Oh,
you know,
Matt.
That the runes.
It is
gone
possible
out
to reserve your skill points.
Okay. Awesome. Thank you.
Hold it back. Okay.
I just realized that going unarmed makes me do no damage extra.
Yeah.
Of course not. I figured it. I thought
it's just status effects.
I thought I saw crushing. Right. I thought it meant I get to crushing, but it's not what
you
get
a weapon.
No, it's type.
Yeah.
If everyone could clear the table, right, please.
I'm saving mine.
Clear you the table.
You get to add the bludgeoning.
Yeah, for one attack.
Right.
Pointless.
Clear the table. The table should be cleared.
Perfect. Excellent. Okay. Y'all are walking down a path right now. And you can begin to see what appears to be it's starting to clear up around you. It looks like it's beginning to become a more like a like it's beginning to transform. The landscape is beginning to transform into a more rural area,
okay,
more urban area. You notice a sign along the path that you're walking as the path begins to turn more into a street, which is right over here. Y'all are like a little ways down. Y'all are a couple miles down this road right here.
Okay.
And you say it says Main Street. Their surviving buildings and remaining landscaping seem to indicate the small town was once very charming. The current inhabitants have made a noble attempt to blend old-world charm with new-world utilitarianism. The vast majority of the buildings have been cannibalized in order to create bottlenecks into the city and also reinforce other key structures. You approach a ramshackle gate made of salvaged lumber and tin, and you hear an elderly man's voice.
Hey there! You! What business you have here?
Oh, goodness! Please, don't yell.
I kind of...
Huh? Speak up!
They say there's business to be had here in Bryson. Is that right? Is that the name of this town? I can't remember.
How far away is this guy from us?
He's up in the gate.
He's up in the gate.
Yeah, y'all approach a gate, like a ramshackle gate,
okay,
along the road.
Right.
As y'all are walking up. And an elderly man calls out, "Who the halt? Who goes there?"
All right.
I said what I said.
I'm sorry. What did you say?
Sorry. I said, "We hear there's business to be had here in Bryson. We're seeking glory and riches, mainly riches."
Every bandit seeking riches all the time.
Well, how dare you call me a bandit?
You ain't gonna be starting no trouble in our town, are you?
We're merely wanderers. We've just been attacked by trogs and coyotes. We need to seek shelter.
You hear the old man begin to groan as he walks away from the gate top, and you can kind of sort of through the beams of the gate see him walking down a ladder And he unlatches the gate and opens it up, and he says, "Well, go on in, then."
"You're my savior."
"Yes, whatever, whatever. Just go. Go on. Hurry up. Before bandits come along, I need to close this gate."
"Ho! Come on, guys!" I help hustle everybody in.
As I walk by, I go, "Thank you."
He gives you a disgusted look. And then from then on, he avoids eye contact.
I just kind of give him a nod as I walk by.
He barely acknowledges you.
"Oh, I didn't catch your name."
He seems kind of like a grouchy old man. "That's not important. You just keep on going down. The town's over that way."
Okay.
"Just don't be starting no trouble."
"We heard you the first time."
"Yes, no trouble."
"Man, he is ornery, isn't he?"
"Yes."
"Well, he knows you mean trouble."
"Y'all walk."
From what I've seen, most humans, when they get old, they get cranky. Is that correct?
Yeah, for the most part, yeah.
"You seem pretty cranky already.
I'm always cranky."
"Look, he is old too."
Y'all begin walking down the main street. Mm-hmm. You're still a good ways out from what appears to be like the main part of the town, a couple of miles probably. And you see on the road ahead of you a group of people that seem to be talking. You notice one man with seven guys behind him. They all kind of look like a cutthroat band of men. The one guy that seems to be speaking for the whole group is he's talking to another guy who seems to be very well dressed. The well dressed man has another big guy with him, wearing a cowboy hat, and two other look like almost like hunters or woodsmen that are with them. As you get closer, you begin to hear what they're saying. The clean-cut guy, it says... Oh, I'm sorry. The guy with the band of people behind him, he says,
"Mayor Fredericks, all we want is to have a roof over our heads, fields to tend, and a little bit of safety. You don't know how bad it is out here. We got wolf women, deer men, and all sorts of bad walking around out here, killing my men. Just get rid of your new pets and leave us in peace."
The clean-cut man, obviously who he was talking to, Fredericks, runs his hand through his thinning hair. "James, you know I can't give up the hotel. Those things have a right to a home, just like any of us. I say leave them alone. You have the entire lake. A more secure home you'll not find in these parts." The man becomes animated, throwing his arms out in frustration. "I can't believe you're going to pick a bunch of monsters over your own kind. All you have are kids and old people. You know this pack of old farts can't protect themselves. Your young have either joined us or run off to find a city. You're all alone, and we're your own kind." Fredericks glances towards Hawkins. Towards the big guy with the cowboy hat behind him. And then back to the guy he's talking to. "Really? So you see yourself protecting us?" The man retorts, "You're damn right. We're equipped and willing. All you have to say is yes," as he casts a twisted grin towards one of his men behind him. "You know, James, things are getting pretty rough around here. 3 days ago, someone killed the Clayton family." The man nods as Frederick continues. "In fact, we all figured it was one of those strange folk who wandered in from the mist."
"Like one of those little monsters."
"Yes. Like one of those little monsters."
"You see, we need each other."
"Not quite." He takes a moment to appreciate the confusion on the man's face before continuing. "You see, it wasn't until little Jenna wandered in that we got a clearer picture of what happened." The man's eyes narrow and he seems to lose all composure.
"That little tramp lied. We didn't chop up those bodies. It was those monsters you're protecting."
"I never said the bodies were chopped up. And I find it hard to believe an 11-year-old girl can be much of a tramp. You see, her mama told her to hide in the cabinet and be quiet. She watched. It took 2 days of calming her down to get the full story out. Turns out the flotilla is the only wound festering in these parts. It's diseased just like the men who live on it. You have nothing to offer us, Frith. You need us to become a friendly mask to draw outsiders in while you free them of their goods, and you don't care if you have to steal a heart to do it. Those little monsters have shown more gratitude, more willingness to be a part of our community than you ever did. I don't care if they look like us or not. Fredericks calmly steps back from the meeting. His men remain facing the opposing group. He finishes as he turns his back to Frith. We'll take our chances with the freaks before throwing in with the likes of you. Don't come back to Bryson City. Fredericks notices you and begins to calmly walk towards your group.
Oh no.
And Frith and his men angrily turn and leave.
Oh, when they start walking, I gotta stand up and I go, good day!
I stand behind Lance.
We all get behind these demons.
I just kind of look behind and I go,
these are your people, go! And I kind of shove them.
Talk to them. Tell them that we're okay.
I step up as he gets pushed up and Frederick I keep slipping. Extend my hand.
Oh, what's he doing?
Frederick is a well-trimmed, well-kempt, neat-looking man.
The mayor, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
He is the mayor. Y'all have actually heard from your handler that the mayor of this town is Matt Fredericks. Anyway.
Can you spell his name real quick?
Fredericks. It's right there.
Oh. I should be able to remember that.
All right. He walks up to you, giving you each an eye, taking your hand, shaking it.
I extend my hand after.
Okay. Shakes your hand and says, well, friends, it seems as we're in a bind. I got bandits making all sorts of mischief, missing medics, and of all things, a damn spaceship crashing near the river.
Spaceship?
Spaceship.
Medics?
Yeah.
Near the river.
All I know about UFOs are from pre-broadcast movies, but my hunters told me that there were some lights still on. I figure if lights are on after that thing crashed 2 weeks or so ago, there must be a mighty nice power source on board. And, you know, having access to that thing would make life a whole lot better for our little community.
I would be very interested in taking a look at this spaceship.
I'd be much more interested in the medics you mentioned.
I just need some ammo.
The medics? Well, we've unfortunately lost a... we've got a couple of medics that were going out trying to find some herbs missing.
Yes, and do you have more medics in town?
Yes, we actually do, We have one. We have our Angie Carr. She is our local doctor, I guess you could call her. You know, she was a nurse, you know, pre-signal. But she's used her skills and she's become one of the greatest doctors this town has seen. She's even performed operations successfully. And she's got a little bit of herbalism knowledge ever since. Gained a little bit of knowledge in herbalism also ever since.
Yeah.
Ever since the signal.
Yeah. Okay. You know, this spaceship thing's gonna be there, like, you know, probably for a while.
We should go and see about tending our wounds.
Yeah, man. I mean, I got, like, 10 wolf little coyote bites on me, you know? Those little pesky buggers.
Yes, pesky buggers.
You know, now that I think about it, didn't we come across some bodies on the way here?
Oh, yeah. They didn't have a whole lot on them. There's not a whole lot to say about them.
Did you see something, like a drawing?
Oh, yeah, yeah. I've got this picture. And I pull out the picture that I folded up.
He holds his hand out to see the picture. He takes the picture and...
Oh, we also found this little tiny piano. It's so cool.
He tenderly holds the hand-drawn picture and examines it. His eyes begin to tear as he says, my baby drew this for them when she was little. I had no idea they cared so much. After a moment, he composes himself and continues. You find me what I need, and I'll make it right by them. I swear to God I will, but for now, the living need us more than the dead. I need that power supply from that ship before those bastards on the flotilla get a hold of it. My hunters are scouting it out now, but they are probably ill-equipped to do the job. They should be back within a week or so. If the power is still on, we'll do what we have to get it back here. Now, I have an appointment to make, but if you gentlemen are interested in helping us out in our fair town of Bryson, I would I would be more than happy to meet with you in my office later on this evening.
Yes, we can definitely do that. In the meantime, could you tell us where to get ammo and heal these wounds?
Well, there's a an old hospital over in the town. You ought to be able to find it. Just go on down the road there until it ends and take a right.
Where are we at?
There's a general store as well.
More like here.
Okay. Owned by Sal, and he might be able to fix you up with a few things that you need. But also, if y'all are willing to help us, then I can also maybe gather up a few things as well. And I can have it ready in my office just for some of the supplies, at least, that we can spare.
Oh!
That would be
Yes! Yes!
All right. Well, very good. Well, if you don't mind, I must be going.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Pleasure to meet you, gentlemen. I'll be waiting for you in my office. You'll find my office in the courthouse.
Thank you for your hospitality.
We'll see you in the courthouse.
Very good.
I extend my hand to shake his hand before he leaves.
He shakes your hand.
I just nod.
And then hurriedly walk. He wouldn't shake your sword.
No, the swords go down. I have three little
nubs.
They're like little elbow things. Three little fingers.
I begin hastily walking towards the hospital pharmacy.
Okay.
Not a lot of fingers.
You begin to walk towards the pharmacy.
I have three fingers and a thumb.
I start following behind him, just observing all the buildings as we go.
Okay. Y'all get one skill point each.
Yeah.
As we're walking, I go, you do realize you have no money, right?
We have wire. We have things.
As y'all begin to walk off, that's right.
I got wire I'm going to trade in, bro.
Matt Frederick turns around and says, oh, one more thing. And he pulls out 4 hoops of Metzal currency, which is 5. Or, I'm sorry. String is 20.
Yeah, string is 20. A hoop is five.
So he pulls out 8 hoops and hands 2 to each of you.
Oh, nice.
Nice.
Hoop, shall loop. So we each get 2 hoops?
Yep.
Which is 10.
10 Metzal.
Mm-hmm. All right, nice. All right, cool.
Thank you, Matt Fredericks.
Nice.
You will definitely make it worth your while.
I guess this is an advance.
I'm sorry, what?
I guess this is an advance.
Yes, to help you get started in town, you'll be able to find rooms and any goods or food that you might need. I know you look at like you might be wary from your travels.
I'm very cautious when people hand out free money.
Oh, I'll take your money.
Well, nothing is ever free. You've promised to help us.
Yes, we did. That's why I was wondering if it was advance.
You could call it that.
All right.
No need to be afraid of everybody, especially when they're handing you money.
Humans don't even trust their own kind.
That's because humans are smart.
You and your bug brain.
Technically, you're correct.
All right. Y'all begin walking down. Adam, will you move your character just a little bit? Let me see the map here. Okay.
On our way towards the pharmacy, I just keep asking people which way it is.
Every once in a while, you'll run into a person. Some of them will give you odd looks. However, there are some people in this town that are animorphs as well. However, y'all don't see any animorphs that are like you. But seldom will you see them. Anyway.
I'm the only animorph.
Yeah. All right. 1 second. Okie dokie. So y'all begin heading down the street. All the way down. Pass by a bank and what appears to be a motel.
Okay.
Motel 6?
Motel 8.
Motel 7.
Yeah.
7. Motel 7. Yeah. Motel 7.
Okay. You reach the end of the T in the road, you take a right, start heading towards the pharmacy.
When we enter into the pharmacy, is there a place where they sell, like, med stuff?
You can ask that.
Oh, well, this one I'm looking at. Like, I'm looking to see if they sell, like, when I first walk in, does it look like
you don't
like
see any signs offering medical supplies.
Okay.
When we walk in, I start just coughing and wheezing and holding my stomach. Doc, I'm hurt bad. I need help.
What's the bluff equivalent?
It's guile.
Guile.
Yeah.
Rolling.
It's untrained.
Guile
so
acting,
it's,
maybe? Or
it's so...
Nat 1.
Okay.
I'm not even bleeding anymore.
Yeah.
It's all dried underneath your throat. All right. No one can even tell you're hurt.
Y'all walk in. A tall, wet, red-headed woman greets the party upon entering through the hospital doorway. She nods towards some empty seats and says, "I'll be with you strangers in a moment. Fill out a form." Well, that is if you can read or just... Never mind. She places the large medical book she was holding on a desk and walks over. Her eyes twinkle as she sees each of you non-humans. And they kind of sparkle with amazement.
She wants to dissect you.
Now, who's first as she immediately walks over to you?
Me!
And begins inspecting your, inspecting all of your interesting mandibles. And
oh, yeah.
Things.
As she starts doing that, I go, "I'm hurt right here."
She's not even looking at your wounds. She's just, like, studying your
She's,
anatomy.
Like, studying, like, how I'm looking at everything?
She's studying your anatomy.
Oh, she is?
Yeah.
Okay. Lady, I said down here, this is where I'm hurt.
And I'm trying to butt in and pointing out my actual wounds.
Wait your turn. I said down here. My eyes are up here.
Hey, lady, I'm up here.
Oh, and she looks at your wound and she says... She says, "Oh, I can treat you in just a moment. It looks like you have a small bit of scratches and scrapes." Mm-hmm. And she walks over to you and begins to study you.
I'm actually hurt pretty decent. I'm down 214 from 25.
Okay. She looks you over and says, "Oh my, you've been bitten and scratched up on, haven't you?"
"Yes, it hurts terribly."
I'm sure it does.
Please,
tell me you have something.
Well, I do have some bandages. Unfortunately,
I'll take them all.
We haven't received any supplies yet for healing salves. We haven't received our supplies yet from our healing salves. Our herbalists that went out are missing.
This is terrible news.
I can help.
However, I can bandage your wounds, and it will help and clean them.
Yes.
Okay. She begins to bandage and clean y'all's wounds.
I've licked my own wounds enough.
She keeps trying to put a bandage on. You're like, it's like, stop.
What's going on, you?
She helps us out. She bandages us up.
Oh.
Does that do anything to her hit points?
Doctor, I didn't get your name.
Oh, my name is Angie.
Oh, you're the best doctor.
Angie Carr.
To have ever caressed my fur.
Oh, well, I'm glad you enjoyed it.
I ask her, I go,
"Your herbalist, may I please say, my name is Carex. Carexix."
Ooh.
Whenever we shake her hands, I do a little rub. I'm trying to think of what it is, what skill it is to... it's guile?
I mean, that's the...
To, like, hit on her?
Converse, guile, converse.
Converse, so I'm doing it untrained. My presence is 1, so I get +0.
I can't remember.
So I'm going to try to flirt with her. I got a 16.
Okay, I don't even know what she needs to roll. Okay.
So it's not that 20.
She probably looks about as good as you do.
Oh, really?
And she's kind of an older lady.
Oh, I don't care. I don't care what she looks like.
She's human, right?
She happily accepts your advances.
Okay, enthusiastically,
really.
I too branch off into the herbalism craft. You said that a couple of your herbalists went missing.
Yes, one of them was my daughter.
Oh, Really?
I'm worried sick.
You have a daughter?
Yes.
Oh,
stop.
You don't look like you're old enough to have a daughter. Stop. Okay. Well, I would love to go help. You know, if there's another herbalist out there, I'd love to go and try to save them. But is there anything you could maybe help me out? I'm trying to get some advancements in making my own teas and tinctures. Is there anything you might have for sale?
Well, she walks back to a cabinet and opens it and starts rummaging through it.
As she's rummaging, I would love to risk my life to make sure that your daughter is back here safe. If there's anything you could tell me where I could go and find her, that would be much appreciated.
And as, like, as I see her digging this stuff, I'm like...
Well, my supplies are very, very low. As I said, we haven't had anyone come back yet.
I understand. I whisper to myself, they will be needing them.
I suppose if you have the metsal, then I could part with some of it.
Oh.
Antibiotics will go for about 240 metsal.
Okay, a little bit of a troll vomit comes out. 200.
Oh, but if you want some chamomile tea, just for sleeping, it's a sleep aid. It's
I
just one metsal.
Okay, I buy one.
He hands you a bag of chamomile tea.
Thank you.
I have something that I think is highly worth the price of your antidote.
And yeah, I'll pull out this tiny piano. And a guitar with no strings.
She begins to look over the piano and the guitar. You're trying to get an antibiotics?
Yes.
And she says, well, you know, maybe if you threw in another 30 or 20 metsal, then I can give you the antibiotics. But other than that, I can't really afford to lose them.
You're killing me, woman!
Well, I think it was whatever attacked you that's killing you.
Your relentless spirit is attacking me!
She giggles and gives you a little pat on the head.
Okay.
It says, well, try so hard. Without it.
Is there, now that we're done with our conversing of purchasing items, is there any information you can give us? We'll keep a lookout for your daughter.
Well, I don't know what kind of information you're looking for. I have a lot of information.
Any information that would point us toward your daughter? Or any of the herbalists that went missing? We'd love to help you out. You are so kind to help us out.
Well, you know, I appreciate that. And, you know, I do know a few rumors.
Rumors?
You know, I've heard mist incursions have been happening in the cities. However, something seems to be causing them to happen closer to Bryson City.
What is that?
Well, I mean, I came from a mist in the city. I can attest to that.
Well, I don't know what it is. Well, that's where most of your types come from, yes?
Yes.
What are you trying to say?
What do you mean, you types?
Animals.
Oh. Yeah, she's talking about you.
Now, we get that.
Yeah.
Stall on your end. We don't see it. It says there's an excellent stream.
Wait, what? What's up?
He's asking if there's. It seems like it's kind of stalling out, but it might be his internet. Yeah.
He sent me a message earlier saying that he was experiencing some bad internet connection issues.
Okay. It says that we have an excellent stream. We need to keep going though.
Okay. Yeah. Let's keep wrapping it up.
Yep.
Wrap
it up.
Angie says. If you lay down on these cots, you're more than welcome to rest here for a bit.
No, we need to keep going. We need to go to the store. We need to meet up with the mayor.
Oh my gosh, you don't want to rest?
Trust me, I want to get to the store.
Oh,
we need to refresh. He doesn't have any bullets, and he doesn't have a shoe.
We don't all have to go to the store together.
That is true,
we can meet back up here before our rendezvous with the mayor.
But whose hand will I hold?
Take my strong arm.
But let's go. Thank you so much.
He's got a point. Maybe I can trade off this guitar.
Angie, thank you so much. Thank you so much.
She takes your hand.
I bring her hand up to my mandibles. I go...
That is so disturbing.
What is disturbing about this?
No, the question is, what isn't?
I just give out a sigh and walk out the door.
Okay. So, we're going to cross the bridge. I guess we kind of converse with some people and try to get some directions. Are there signs that kind of point to where, like, certain things are in the town?
Absolutely.
Do we need to kind of... Because he says...
The mayor gave you directions to the courthouse.
Well, we're going to go to the general store and then the courthouse.
Okay, right. He says the general store is next to the courthouse.
All right, so we make our way in the general store. There's like a little bell, I guess, that...
You walk into the general store.
Ding, 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 dong.
All right. You walk into the general store, and you see a man with a little bit of a pot belly and a straw hat. And sitting inside of there, and he seems to have a clipboard, and he seems to be taking inventory of items that he has on his shelves.
Yep.
He turns when you walk in and says, "Oh, welcome. How y'all doing today?"
Doing pretty
terrible.
Good.
Look at my terrible and grievous wounds.
It looks like the nurse done checked it out for you.
She's the best ever.
Okay.
Tell me, sir, what weapons do you have for... what? But precisely, what wares do you have for me?
Well,
I've not got much coin, but I do have this fantastic piano. And this air guitar.
Air guitar.
I made it up myself. I coined that term right now.
Anyways. All right, so we have Sal's hardware inventory.
All
right. Listed right here, if y'all would like to look at that.
All right.
I start perusing the aisles as he's talking.
Start listing it out loud as you go down. List the items, please.
He has gasoline, batteries, a backpack.
He's got a blaster rifle blueprint.
Oh my gosh. Mm-hmm.
Is
glass specimen bottles, ointment bottles.
Okay.
Blaster rifle blueprint.
Blue canvas sheeting, car alternator, crowbar, crystal kit, dental... pick, stainless steel, electric recharge kit, electronic kit, fiberglass and resin kit, a hammer, a carpenter's hammer, a hoe, a fishing hook, mechanical kit, metal craft kit, monofilament line, 200-foot unit, mortar and pestle, nails, non-organic kit, organic kit, pickaxe, pitchfork, electronic set of pliers, a mechanic set of pliers, and a metal set of pliers, scalpel, shovel, solar panel, spikes, acetylene torch. Okay, sorry. Traps kit and electrical wire and a wood kit.
Cool. I want to get the organic kit. How much is that?
Well, the organic kit. It's going to cost you 65 metsal.
How much is for this wire?
I like... I lay a spool of 10 feet of wire.
I'll give you 20 metsal for it.
And then...
No, I need that. One day.
I lay the wire on there and I go...
Oh, gosh.
And I go, I have 40. Is there any way... you might be able to lower the price.
I'm gonna do some dial.
You have 40 metal?
I have 40. I have 10 plus the wire, which is
20. He gets 40 to the group, so each of y'all got.
Right, that's what it was. So I have 10.
He says that he will trade
that.
He said that he will trade the wire for 20 metal.
Okay. So it's 20 plus my 10. I have 30, and it says 60?
65, I think.
For the organic kit?
Yep. Organic kit, 65.
Ah, I can't get it. Ah!
Are you still wanting to get rid of this wire, though? Are you still wanting to get rid of the wire? He pulls out,
Yes.
It's a terrible deal.
He pulls out a string.
I'm sorry.
Right.
He pulls out a string of metal.
Okay.
And takes the wire and puts the string of metal.
So I got 20 now. Plus my 10, so I have 30.
You got 30.
I didn't see any,
string and tubes.
Any ammunition in that list.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. I ain't got no ammunition over here. If you're looking for inventory, you might want to go to Smith-Smithy.
Smith-Smithy? Where's that at? Where's that located at?
He points you down the ways to a building right off over here.
All right.
Well, you never told me how much you would give me for this grandiose piano and this air guitar.
That's air guitar.
I'll tell you in just a second.
Colton, pass it.
I'm telling you, once we get your ammo, it'd be great. We'll be set.
I agree.
I put the hoops. I wear the Mets out.
Sold!
How much?
I can't believe I gave that to you.
He nods and he gives you 150 Mets out. For those 2 hours.
Wow.
150. Nearly priceless. You got you a deal.
Hey, buddy. Hey.
I'm not even late.
Hey, just you want to give me that organic kit? Hey.
Yeah, dude.
Mr.
That's how I'm
Moneybags Firefox. You're getting nicknames all day now.
Yeah. It's because I call the piano grandiose.
There's not no sub.
No.
Anyways. Continuing on. Anyone else have any business that they would like to do?
No.
At the general store. What would y'all like to do next?
Go buy poisons.
I want to go to this. I want to go to this Smith place.
You
it was again.
Begin
was
heading to Smith-Smithy.
Smith-Smithy.
Mm-hmm. I follow.
Yep, we all re-roll together.
Roll deep up in this town.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Y'all approach the Smith shop. You see over in the distance beyond the building is a forge.
Mm-hmm.
And it actually is a good distance away from the building.
Is this the building right here?
Yeah.
As you walk into the building, you notice Robert Smith is not what you think a typical blacksmith would look like. He's tall, lanky, and looks like he's in his, seems kind of clumsy. Looks like he's in his late 30s. His dark skin is broken by patches of silvered scars and old burns. His shop is soot-stained, even though the forge is approximately 50 feet from the building. Robert's shop is a 10 by 30 foot building found, his shop is that's it. Y'all can roll observation checks now.
Yes.
This place is filthy. I'm not going in there.
Nice.
I'll wait outside.
I got a 17.
No.
All
right. I didn't get anything to talk about.
Y'all too notice that burnt timbers and scorched stone indicate the building has been set on fire multiple times. But you also notice that an ingenious fire suppression system with hoses and spray nozzles crisscross the ceiling. Several large tubs attached to the side of the building capture rainwater to fuel the suppression system.
Alright.
So how can I help you boys?
What do you have to sell? Looking for wares, ammunition.
Oh yeah, I got
maybe
some stuff.
Maybe some steel-toed boots. Mine kind of got messed up.
They lost their souls.
You only got one boot.
You're like always kind of you're like standing with the lean.
Yeah.
I think I got to see it first last time.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
We'll get to see it
Smith's
first.
Smithy. So well, if you all got up and looked at it, then everybody could look at it at the same time while it's on table.
Yeah, let's do that.
That didn't work last time.
Yeah, it's going to work
this
time.
Let's just get up.
Smithy, where we at? So we got an anvil, brick forge, crowbar, dagger, homemade flamethrower, longsword, machete, mech bow, metal pipe, oxygen bottle, pitchfork, pliers, some plier metal set. What is that? A repacker?
I see what I want.
Rogue shotgun, shovel, and whistle-mounted crossbow. A wrist-mounted crossbow.
It's blueprints. So expensive.
Yeah. All that is really, really expensive. I cannot afford anything. I will go
somebody
wait.
Somebody here can afford.
I go wait outside.
Yeah.
I'm out there talking to my fox friend.
My new best friend.
What can I do to get? I'll look at you. Gruel.
You have any jobs you need done?
Yeah. Is there anybody missing that you know? That any loved ones?
Any sulfur in there?
Does he have any sulfur in there?
Yes.
It's a blacksmith, so I would assume so.
Oh? I tuck tail.
I came outside to talk to you, now you go inside.
And I duck inside.
You have that effect on people.
Yeah, I think so. Alright.
Hang on, let everybody else do theirs.
I'm just browsing around at all.
You can't afford anything?
Nah.
Yeah.
I don't think I can afford anything.
Okay. You walk in.
I'm staring at the shotgun.
Observe.
You're like,
I haven't rolled that.
I didn't want that.
Never mind.
Oh, wow.
I don't even see him.
You take a few minutes to actually find him. Yeah. So, anybody else need anything done?
Nope.
I just kind of stand and I point. I go, how much is this?
What are you pointing at?
Shotgun.
How much is the shotgun?
Like 150?
250?
580.
580?
That'll run you about 580 metsal. It's a real fine piece, though.
It looks fine.
Mm-hmm.
Fortunately, I'm broke. Can I trade you this for it? I put my pistol on top.
I don't think that quite covered.
Okay, then. I just take my pistol, put it back in my... And I just sit there and stare.
Yeah, he looks at your pistol for a second, and he goes, you know what? I think I actually might have something for you. And he pulls out a box of 9mm rounds and opens it up, and there are 2 rounds inside.
How much for that?
Well, give me 5 metsal and it's yours.
Okay, and I hand you 5.
It gives you 2 bullets.
Fantastic. 2 bullets.
Wow. You should put some of your skill points into it.
Bulleting.
Yeah. All right. I'm like waiting outside, and like right when I see like the first person, I'm like, can we go?
I'm not outside yet because I'm still trying to find the guy.
You're so let's go.
You're still trying to find what?
I want to talk to the guy.
I want to talk to the guy.
What do you want? Okay, you find the guy.
You might very well be the first favorite person on my list for today.
Oh, why is that?
I bet you have
some... You find something you want to buy?
Oh. I'm betting you have some sulfur around here.
I might have a little bit, but I use it.
Where do you get yours from?
Well, it's honestly just my stockpile from what I found in this here smithy whenever I took over the place.
I'll buy some from you.
I'm sorry, not really much of it's for sale. What you need sulfur for?
The name is Firefox. And I use sulfur for magic.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, I suppose I could...
I'll pay a premium price.
I suppose I might could give you a little tiny amount.
Okay.
And he gets like a little bag, like the size of like a small coin pouch.
Okay.
And puts like... We'll say, like...
I think the pouch size is, like, 20 foci.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Yeah. He gets that, and he gets a little scoop and fills up the pouch, and then closes it up. Oh, this stuff smells terrible.
Smells like love.
And he puts it down on the counter and says, "Now, you're the first person I've actually had come and ask me about buying this stuff, so let's just say you give me, for that sulfur, give me 30 metsal and it's yours."
Sold.
All right.
I'll give you 35 if you promise I can come back at a later date and get more.
Well, that all depends on whether or not I find more.
Well, I'll give you 35 to get me into your thoughts. Fair enough.
That's fair to me. He takes the 35 metsal from you and slides the little pouch over to you.
Y'all hear me from outside? Cha-ching!
Where is that list?
There it is.
Yeah. Okay. Y'all want to talk to me more or anything like that?
I'm outside. I'm sitting at, like...
I load my two bullets in, and I load it in my gun, and I just kind of sigh, and I walk out.
You got two rounds now.
When y'all walk out, I'm, like, sitting Indian style, and I'm like this with my claw drawing in the dirt.
Get away from this!
You should have eaten it.
Let me taste it.
Now you only have 10 uses left.
I'm like, that's you.
5 uses.
Pure magic in a bag.
Pure magic.
Get a grin from ear to ear.
Can we please go to the courthouse? I'm wondering what he has for us.
Are you done looking at
that? Maybe
it's
some more bullets, I hope.
You do need it?
Who needs bullets when you have sulfur?
that guy.
That guy right there.
This guy needs bullets.
All right.
Lots of bullets.
He's got two thumbs and need bullets.
Is anyone like look at the prices on his stuff and then try to
shop around?
Haggle later?
Possibly, yeah.
Well, now you just gotta ask.
Well, yeah, but like I'm assuming everybody's prices are different, right?
Probably.
I have to figure out if this is...
I doubt it from this town.
I mean, I guess there's no market value on it.
Right.
There's probably like a going rate for things in this town.
Yeah.
More than likely, depending on supply and demand.
Yeah, I gotcha.
You may be able to haggle, you know, a little.
All right, so what is it that y'all would like to do now that you have left the Smith's Smithy?
Courthouse.
Yeah.
You start walking back down the street, heading towards the courthouse.
Yes.
The bank can get a loan.
Okay.
What?
The bank can get a loan.
To go to the bank and get a loan, yeah, you would be thinking about that.
Buy whatever you want. Pay for it later.
Two sessions later.
You
like,
will become a banker.
Yeah.
Despite the area the town has once covered, despair and looting have reduced many of the buildings to kindling form. Only a few older brick buildings have survived the 40 years of neglect. Upon entering the courthouse, you see that basically the lobby of the courthouse has been turned into the mayor's office. Matt Fredericks is sitting in there, and he immediately stands up, walks over to you, and says, "Here you go, friends. It's about time. Glad to see that you finally made it. Well, let's get right down to business. Besides my missing medics that you have so kindly found,
the dead bodies.
You
yeah,
did.
Oh, those.
You're just now making the connection? Oh my god. I made the connection instantly.
Yeah, that guy didn't make the connection.
Oh,
he didn't
have
all
the
reasons
that you And the space. Okay,
that's
besides
why
my missing medics, which you have so kindly found, and a spaceship full of god knows what, I have these duties to attend to. The board contains slips of handwritten requests from the mayor's office. As he.
We haven't gone on the spaceship yet.
Signals to the board.
Quick question. Do those bandages do anything for us?
Points what? Reality.
No, I mean, it's gonna make y'all heal after you rest.
Okay.
Alright, he says, "Thank you so much for finding those two, medics that we had gone missing. If you could do me a favor."
Yes.
Speak with Angie Carr.
She's a gem.
Her daughter is one of those two women.
That we found
if
dead?
If you could let her know, I'm sure she would be very grateful to hear about it.
Glad we didn't mention anything in the first place.
However, I have been able to gather a few items for you to help you, as you are going to be helping us. And he turns around and he says, right this way, and he walks y'all into another room. You see a table before you. There are 4 backpacks, 20 days of trail rations. Are y'all writing things down?
Backpack.
Each of y'all get 1 backpack.
What kind of backpack?
A backpack.
Okay, there's a light and a heavy. Or
sure, it's a light.
Fine, light.
You get each 5 days of trail rations. You get 1 gallon equivalent in water bottles. 1 fishing hook and 50 feet of fishing line.
Hold on, you're...
Okay.
Man.
Now, he gives y'all a choice. Y'all can either take a 10x10, 10 foot by 10 foot square canvas of material, tent quality, or a bedroll. The tent weighs 10 pounds, and the bedroll weighs 3.
How many would we put in a tent?
It's 10x10 feet square, so comfortably 4.
Or we each can get a bedroll?
So we each...
Or just one
each of y'all can take a tent if you want.
Okay.
Oh, each of us...
We need to take 1 tent and 3 bedrolls then, because we can all fit in a tent.
1, 2, 3. Bedroll.
Bedroll! As long as someone else carries the tent.
write down what you take.
I'll take the tent.
Yeah,
I'll take a bedroll.
As long as someone else carries it.
You also are allowed to get either...
I'm the smallest guy here.
Each of you is also either allowed to take 50 foot of hemp rope, which weighs 10 pounds,
okay,
or 1 flint and steel set.
I'll take a flint and steel.
Rope. You said 50 feet?
50 feet. Mm-hmm. He also gives you...
I'll take rope.
A Bryson City Rail Depot B&B. Beds and bacon. It's a 10-bed B&B for all of you to stay while you're working for him.
Nice.
You have free stay there.
Nice.
And then finally... He says, all right, and then, now I have, he pulls out a hunting knife, puts it on the table, just 1.
Right. Probably the guy that
take
needs
a knife.
A weapon. Well, let's see what else he's got.
He says, I also have, which would y'all rather have, a baseball bat or a machete?
Is the baseball bat electrified?
Well,
choose, y'all, the whole party can choose 1. Either a baseball bat or a machete.
PA or PM?
Somebody speak up and just say something, damn it.
We'll just pick in a minute. It's fine.
What would you like? You don't have a weapon.
I'd rather have the baseball bat.
The baseball bat?
It's a P. It's PM.
Are you the only one that has a gun?
Yes.
He looks you over and says, actually, I think I have something for you. You probably don't need any of these.
I don't know. I've been kicking wolves.
And then he turns and opens up a gun case.
Oh, well.
Hey, y'all have the
my attention is strictly on the gun case.
He pulls out
right
a
there.
45. He pulls out a 45
awesome.
Revolver.
Uh huh.
And he pulls out a 12 gauge pump action shotgun. Which one?
I immediately go for the shotgun.
You know we get more.
All right.
You get excited. You're like, boom.
There also is a box of shells that he grabs. All
right.
And it contains 8 shells.
Yes.
Nice.
I got a 12 gauge pump shotty.
Now is the pump action on that? Is that an actual action?
No. I don't think so.
What do you mean?
No, you can feed 8 rounds into it, so...
As an action?
Yeah.
Okay, to reload it?
Yeah.
But pumping it doesn't require anything.
No,
no,
it's just like
an action, basically.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you only shoot once per round?
Well, the basic.
Yeah.
Unless I put my 2 skill points that I've been saving and do shot.
Boom, boom!
yeah. Okay, so y'all do not get the 45 revolver.
Yeah.
Y'all need to choose whether or not you get a baseball bat or a machete.
I want the hunting knife.
PM.
Yeah,
what's the
PM?
Machete?
And then he has 1 hunting knife.
PM.
I take the hunting knife.
No.
Give him the hunting knife.
No, my PM is only 1.
Just let him have the hunting knife.
I'm sure the machete is PM.
Take the hunting knife.
If
okay,
y'all
that
can,
way if you run out of shells.
Now, if y'all can find out who killed my medics, I will give you each. They're scavenging creatures. I'm pretty sure it wasn't them. I fear it might have been bandits. And I would need proof. But I will give each of you 50 metzal. Now, if you will, that's about all I have for you right now. See me when you finish around town, and I might have more information, and perhaps my scouts will be back, and I can give you more information concerning the crashed ship.
Okay.
All right.
Oh, we'll take the baseball bat.
Okay.
All right. You get the hunting knife?
What's the machete do?
We're about to PM.
Discuss in a second.
Yeah, right.
All right. So, y'all are able to get the things that Mayor Fredericks is going to gave you, and y'all now are leaving Mayor Fredericks. And this is where we are going to call it a session.
Okay.
All
right.
Thank you, all of our viewers, for watching. I hope you enjoyed the show.
Yep.
Tune back in with us. We are going to announce when we are going to start our next session. So check out our Facebook, watch our stream. I'm sure we're going to end up putting something up there.
Right.
And I hope you all enjoyed it. This is Port City Games. Thanks for watching, everybody. Bye.
Yeah. Take care, guys. Yep. See you later. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Adios.
Bye.
As soon as the stream ends, we'll stop talking.
Yeah, totally. Yeah. All right. See you later.